And good evening, everybody. Welcome to Mar Meredith Gymnasium. Second night in a row, we're here to bring you Russell High School basketball tonight. It's the boys of Jason Strader, first-year coach here at Russell, and Harold Tuckett, who's been down there for some time, like, 125 years. No, not really. Harold Tuckett, the head coach of the Musketeers. 10 minutes away, give or take, the clock stops, so I'm not exactly sure why it's not running now. But we'll have about 15 minutes probably before we get all the action going. Tonight's game here on greenupbeacon.com is brought to you by Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital and the Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network. Also brought to you by First and People's Bank and Trust, our corporate sponsor, the Sungate Alpaca Company, Carmen Funeral Home, Handyman Plus, Stoltz Pharmacy, Ashland Community and Technical College, Buddy Gallion and Greenup County EMS, GreenupBeaconRadio.com, the Hearing Center of Ashland, Ohio University Southern, and Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital, along with the Subways of Superquick. Chick-fil-A also a contributing sponsor as we give away on our contest during the games. Tonight is Russell, their season opener on court here in Mar Meredith Gymnasium. I was fortunate enough not only to know Coach Meredith, but I was here the night that they opened this gym in 1963. Greenup County 1-0 as they enter the game tonight as they beat Johnson Central Monday night 74-70 down in Paintsville. A big win for Harold Tackett's squad. And Russell's, as I said earlier, is tonight is the season opener. Greenup County will play Portsmouth Notre Dame. That game not until December 10th. Russell is on the road tomorrow night in the EKC tournament playing West Carter. Officially, they'll be home again December 15th to face 16th Region powerhouse Morgan County. I do not know if any of the EKC games will be here, and we'll just have to wait and see what happens to us when our broadcast schedule is unfolded. And so from that point, last night, a tremendous game here in the gym, 72-71. Pete Fraley and the Lady Lions of Boyd County came to town, escaping with a one-point win. Up by 18, Russell came back to take a lead. They traded leads through the fourth quarter. A couple missed shots cost the Lady Devils the win, but both teams showed that they're going to be a power to reckon with. Russell, Boyd County, Ashland, Lewis County has shown some prowess. So although Ashland got a 20-point win against them last night down in the honoring Colesboro night. Anyway, Keith Atkins is on camera tonight. We thank you for joining us here at greenupbeacon.com, and we hope that you will stay with us. It'll also be online live, and then, of course, archived tonight. Back in a minute. This is the OLBH Beacon Broadcast Network.
First and People's Bank has six convenient locations to serve you, from South Shore to the main office. First and People's Bank has been serving this area with complete banking services since 1932. Visit the home office near you, First and People's Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
We are the home office. Come visit any of our six locations.
Visit the Sungate Alpaca Company to experience the vibrant cultural heritage of South America and discover the extraordinary luxury fabric called alpaca. Wrap yourself in a stylish alpaca scarf, transform your living room by adding texture and color with a hand-loomed alpaca throw blanket, and add a little extra warmth and cozy fashion with an alpaca hat and matching gloves. Visit sungatealpaca.com for all your alpaca needs. Find us on Facebook for special deals and inventory updates. Shop Sungate Alpaca.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I ask you to please stand as we observe our national anthem. Our national anthem will be played by the Russell High School Band. The colors are presented by the Russell High School Air Force Junior ROTC Color Guard. Commanding tonight's color guard on weather, Cadet Jason Blevins. Carrying the American flag, Cadet Dario Franklin.
carrying the state flag, Cadet Liberty Jacobs, and on weapons, Cadet James Gabler. During the playing of the national anthem, we ask that gentlemen remove their hats and everyone place your right hand over your heart. Please remain standing until the colors have left the court.
Honoring America here at Russell High School. Tonight, it's Russell and Greenup County, 4 minutes away from Mark Cole's announcement of the starting lineups. We'll be back here in just a few moments. This is the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network.
Handyman Plus Services by Aaron Keaton, located in Ashland, Kentucky. Plumbing repairs, drain stoppages, bath remodeling, drywall repairs, painting, ADA bath showers installed. Over 30 years experience. Call or text 606-369-6425 or you can email kyhandymanplus@gmail.com.
Stoltz Pharmacy is now offering patients compounding for their prescription needs. Stoltz Pharmacy is the only pharmacy in the area that is PCCA certified. We can provide you with hormone replacement, neuropathy creams, scar creams, pediatric prescriptions, and we can even help you with your veterinarian needs. If you have any questions, please call 606-834-1052. That's 834-1052. Stoltz Pharmacy in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stoltz Pharmacy.
I go to Ashland Community and Technical College.
Because it's so close.
I go.
For the small class sizes.
I go. Because I can transfer my credits.
I go because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go to get a better job.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons, Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education begins here.
Greenup Beacon Radio Network. This is Keith Adkins. I'm calling all local musicians out there from Greenup, Boyd, Carter, and Lewis County. If you're a singer, songwriter, instrument player, band, we'd love to hear from you and get some of your music to be played on the Greenup Beacon Radio. You can submit all your entries to outcastministry@hotmail.com or to carol@greenupbeacon.com.
Betty Gallion and the Greenup County EMS want you to know the qualified staff is available to you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. For transport, call 833-1515. And for medical emergencies, call 911. Greenup County EMS, when seconds count, accepting Medicaid, private insurance, and private pay. Greenup County EMS.
Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon.
National Championship cheerleaders Greenup County, Candy Berry, the sponsor for, I don't know, I think it's 10 national championships or more. Ready now for our starting lineup. First,
the lineup for the Musketeers. At guard, number one, Jarrell Jackson. At forward, number three, Michael Ebert. At guard, 23, Gage Hughes. At guard, number 30, Christian Wyman.
As we're back ready now, it's Russell and Greenup County here on GreenupBeacon.com. Hank Bond and Keith Atkins high atop Bar Meredith Stadium. Our crow's seat up here. And out to jump for Russell will be Ryan Stump. He'll play the middle tonight for the Red Devils. And he'll jump against number three, Michael Hubbard. And with that, it'll be a loud night tonight. Little talk in the huddle. Stump. Hubbard tapped up. Stump controls it. Raby. Ooh, almost threw it away. Miller back to get it was Hale. And here come the Red Devils. Gage Hughes out front against Bobby Hale. Hale puts it on the floor, loses the dribble, throws it over, stolen away nicely. I believe that's Wyman, yes. And in the lane, there's a shot used it. So quickly, 2-0, and Greenup County is on top. A lot of pressure from Greenup County. In the lane, Hughes. He puts the second one up, and it's 4-0. Comes. Pressure. Throws it ahead. Throws it away. And Jason Strader up. Calmly calls a timeout. Back in 30 seconds. This is the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network.
The Hearing Center at 1505 Carter Avenue in Ashland is the tri-state premier audiology center. The Hearing Center staff has been providing quality hearing and hearing aid services to Eastern Kentucky, Southern Ohio, and Western West Virginia since 1972. The Hearing Center offers four styles of hearing aids that professionals tailor to each patient's personal needs. The Hearing Center, 1505 Carter Avenue in Ashland. Phone 606-324-0465.
Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon.
So some strong defense by the Musketeers has given Greenup County a 4-0 lead, and Jaharrell Jackson has it after the turnover. And they look down in the corner. Joe Bryan up, hollers at the defense on the baseline. And out front with it comes Hubbard. Hubbard with it. One-on-one out front with Raby. Hubbard to the right, down the lane. Stop, shoots it off bounce, comes up short. Rebound comes off to Landon Brewer. Bobby Hale with it. Hale cross courts it. Miller underneath. Stop, up and in! 4-2. Jason Strader up quickly. 4-2. Greenup County, three short. It's the back of the rim, actually long, I guess, not short, right? And it's 4-2. Russell with the ball, quickly turns it over, tapped out of bounds by Gage Hughes as Bobby Hale went to pass it away. And Tanner Miller will throw it in for the Red Devils. 4-2. There's Raby. He tried to shoot it before he had it. Stolen away by Brewer, and a foul, jump ball, and the possession there goes to Greenup County. Jason Strader already out of his coat, Keith. I think he's expecting an exciting game tonight.
I hope so. Been good so far.
4-2, Greenup County lead, 6-14. Turnover, nope, Jaharrell keeps it, picked up Hale. Hale gets pressure in the backcourt from Jackson. Jackson pushes, no call, goes down the way. Up, no good. Ball blocked nicely inside. Out comes Gage Hughes all the way down, lays it up, and in. Now, in the old days, if you slapped the backboard like three did, that was a technical foul.
Yep.
I don't know if it still is or not, obviously. Obviously not. And so ahead it comes to Hale. He turns, pressure underneath. Miller puts it up too hard. Stump puts it up too hard, and we'll go the other way. A lot of action, a lot of speed, up and down. And in the corner, Wireman, three, no good. Rebound. Stump takes it away. He keeps it, kicks it over to Hale. Hale quickly up to Miller. Miller drives all the way down, off balance shot, lays it in, and he'll blow a bucket. Foul against Jaharrell Jackson. 6-4 now. Miller can cut it to a one-point game. First foul on Jackson, first foul of the game, first foul on Greenup County. Up and away, good. So it's a 6-5 game now. Greenup County with the ball and the lead. Up, out of bounds as Wireman took. Landon Brewer to throw it in. Brewer across the time, or Hale across the timeline. Gets a pick from Brewer. Baseline, Raby up off the glass, no good. Rebound comes off the broom. Broom throws it ahead to Hubbard. Underneath, layup Wireman. But an old-style Russell fast break, and it's 8-5. And out of bounds, saved in, top four, last touch. Official was behind the call. That was not who touched it last. It should have been this official right here. Nonetheless, Greenup County gets it. 8-5, they lead, and in it comes. Gage Hughes with it. Squared up against Bobby Hale. In the corner it goes. Wireman. A lot of pressure on defense from both teams. Jackson, he takes it all the way down. He wants to shoot over. Can't. Turns around, spins, drops it. Head ball comes out to Grooms. Grooms will bring it out front. Ryan Stump out on Grooms, one-on-one, chases him to the lane. Landon Brewer knocks it down. Nice, it goes underneath Wireman out of bounds, and it'll be a nice block inside, and it'll be Greenup County ball. Musketeers. Up by three. Hughes backs it out. Cross court to Hubbard. Three. Good! 11-5. A 6-point lead for the Musketeers. And you forget how fast the action is between boys and girls ball until you do one. Hale down the stump. Lays it up. Puts it in. 11-7. Hubbard took steps. No call. Almost knocked away his. Brewer gets it. Raby all the way in, 6-footer, off the glass, no good. Brewer inside, fought four, comes out to Grooms, and here comes Greenup County's Jaharrell Jackson. Quickly up to Gage Hughes, took a step, took a three, no good. Rebound stump, all the way up goes Raby. Raby across the timeline, stops, wants to shoot, can't, gives it to Stump, tried to force it inside, ball comes away, Stump picks it up, it was touched, and it'll go over to Bobby Hale. Jason Strader up, wanting to make a call. Hale, Hale had the lane and tried to pass it to the corner. All the way down, Hubbard takes two steps, no good. Rebound, comes off, no shot. And Gage Hughes is fouled. First Red Devil foul of the night against Bobby Hale. And one foul on each team. Out comes Landon Duvall. And I don't know, I'm going to find it. Seth Atkins, I remember that. Stump is out, Hale to the bench. Stump's been playing hard on the inside, I'll say that. And it comes out front. That's number 10 for Greenup. I'll have to pick it up in a minute. Hubbard, three, no good. Rebound comes off down to Burchett. That's Blake Burchett, number 10. And there's Jaharrell from the free throw line. Good. Greenup County on fire here early in the first quarter. 2:44 to play, up by six. Landon Brewer throws it down to Landon Duvall. Shot, good! 13-9. It's Dalton rather than Landon. Dalton Duvall. I'll get better. Wireman took steps. Out comes Nathan Collins. Stump. Trying to check back in. Tanner Miller out. Sometimes it'd be nice to know what all those numbers meant.
Yeah.
There's Stump with it. Stump. Raby. Raby drives all the way down. Kicks to the corner. There's a three, no good, hit the side, comes off, stolen inside, Greenup County keeps it. They're gonna call a foul on, I can't believe it really. They're gonna call a foul on Seth Atkins. Seth Atkins out for Russell. Dalton Duvall, ahead it comes. Atkins picks up Hubbard. There's a three. No good. Comes off out of bounds. So with it out front is Atkins. Is it the stump inside of the ball? Pass a little high and it goes out of bounds. 4-point lead for Greenup County, 1:42 to play. Greenup County's missed a couple of the last couple trips, but they have been on fire. Nice move in there. Nope, steps called on Hubbard. Never put the ball on the floor. You're never going to get away with that. Miller in. Landon Brewer in. They'll bring Nathan Collins out. Landon Brewer back out for Dalton Duvall. And Bobby Hale will check in at the next dead ball. He'll probably come in for Atkins. I think I thought Bobby Hale was coming out. Raby with it, right side. Atkins drives down, wants a shot, takes that. Bobby Hale will check in. Bobby Hale will check in for Atkins. 13-9. He won that shot too bad, Keith. That's what happens to you. Nice crowds on both ends from the schools and the Land Hughes free throw line group. 15-9 with 1:11 to play. Greenup County has led from the start. Now again by 6 points. Bobby Hale, he gets pressure, and there's going to be a foul called against number 13, who is Jordan Hill. Wouldn't any doubt about it. Second foul. 2 fouls. Nothing big. Just don't confuse me too bad, okay? Tanner Miller to throw it in. Nowhere to go. Comes back into Hale. Hale against Harold Jackson. Comes across and stops. Brady with it. He'll go right. Bobby Hale. Three! Goal! 15-12. 48 seconds to play. First quarter. Greenup County up by three. Double dribble. Turned it over. Gage Hughes. Unhappy with the call. Coach tacking up, saying he needs to calm down a little bit. Normally, Harold will fold his arms if he's unhappy. He was talking to him. Harold's a great coach. Down for McDowell. Hale against Hughes, corner. Brady comes out, shoots a six-footer off the glass. No good, tapped around. Landon Brewer on the back. And it's a foul against the Red Devils. And that's McKee. Jacob McKee in for Russell to send Ethan Raby to the bench. Full court press by Russell. Here comes Burchett up for Greenup County. He walks. You can tell the pressure of the game by the amount of walks. Both teams trying to do their absolute best. Well coached and well conditioned. Miller goes into McKee. McKee, the football quarterback for Russell's football team. Down the lane he goes to the corner. Three! Hits the side, comes off, tipped around stump. Greenup County picks it up. That's Hill. Stolen away, stuck, up and in. It's a one-point game, and the quarter will end. Ball went out of it. Unless they get a massive half-court shot off, the quarter will end with a score 15-14, Greenup County. Waited too long. No good. 15-14. Greenup County leads it. I don't know. Did we go off? Maybe we did. Nope, we didn't go off. We're still here. End of one. It's Greenup County 15 and Russell 14. This is the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network. The first stop, 15-14. Greenup County with the lead. They've led by six on two occasions. And now, quarter number two with the Red Devils, the first possession. Landon Brewer down in the corner getting a five count. Pressure gives it to Raby. Raby drives down, stops, puts it up. It's blocked twice. Back on defense. Here comes Harold Jackson. Picks it up, kicks to the corner. Wireman. Wireman walks, comes across. They're going to call a foul on Stump. I don't think, for some reason, I don't think Jason's going to sit down, do you?
No, he's not sitting down today.
No, not for the rest of it. In the corner. Hubbard, Hughes, no good. That three came off, and we'll throw it length of the floor. Great defensive play by Hughes. You can't out-throw Gray Hughes, I'll tell you now. In the lane, off balance, off the glass, no good. Stump down, they fight for it, and it'll be Greenup County's ball down underneath. Russell and Greenup County from Meredith Gym tonight. In the lane, nice block inside. He'll save it, but that was a great block on Grooms. Shot up and a foul on Stump. Things happen so fast, you can't keep up with the numbers, Coach. Usually takes the first meeting for me to get it. We have lots of games scheduled this year, some on the road. Lots of things going on. Stay tuned with us. Watch the Beacon on Monday as we'll join, try to explain to you all the changes we're making with the Beacon Media Group. Keith Atkins, Hank Bond, Allison Martin, Evan Tice, and, of course, Marilyn. I never leave Marilyn out. Absolutely.
Most important part right
That's
there.
Right, and Carol.
Yeah, don't forget Carol.
No. And Sadie.
Sadie.
That's right. I'll tell you the story. It's the next dead ball. Hale over to Tim, McKee. I call him Tim.
Yes.
Jacob. Three. Yes! Christian Wireman with the three. 19-14. Steal inside. Hubbard up and in. 21-14. Back out to a 7-point lead. I believe maybe the biggest lead of the night for the Musketeers. Off the foot of Hubbard. New 10 count will start. Tanner Miller, he'll throw it in under the Greenup County basket. Facing full court pressure by the Musketeers. And they guard the inbound, but it comes into McKee. Double team. Hay on a foul will be called against Austin Grooms. Sadie went to the Russell Christmas parade last night. I told her mom when it was over, she wasn't too Santa Claus enthused, but she said, I've eaten all my Halloween candy. I've now replenished my supply. My kind of girl.
There you go.
21-14. Bobby Hale out front. Nice pick from Miller. Should have given it to Miller and didn't. Hesitated, went to the corner. Hale, he wants that three, but he's too deep. Here's McKee in the lane, stops, pops from six, no good. Rebound comes off, McKee fights for it, gets it back, turns it over. Knocked down by Landon Brewer. He hit the ball, not the arm, but nonetheless, a foul's a foul against Landon Brewer, and that's the sixth foul against the Red Devils. And we got a new one gonna check in. Number 25 for Russell, Jared Fannin. Head it comes, they'll stop it up there. Grooms gives it off to Hubbard, who breaks in, and Russell needs a timeout. Frazier's not gonna take one with 5:53 to play. Little out of control. Head it comes underneath, up and off the glass and in. Nice left-handed layup by Jared Fannin. A quick two for Fannin makes it a 7-point game. Musketeers with the lead and the ball, pressuring backcourt. Head it comes to Hubbard. Hubbard's gonna drive in. Puts it up, no good. Tapped out of bounds by Grooms. Miller. Comes into Bobby Hale. Jason Strader active on that bench, isn't he?
Yeah,
Working them hard. Miller in the lane, left side it goes over to Fannin. There's Miller, right-handed, up off the left side. Nice little layup, 23-18, down to five. Ball comes ahead to Hughes. Hughes gets pressure from Hale. He'll drive around, try to shoot it, kicks it out, Hubbard. Hubbard stops, pops, lays it up, no good. They're going to call a block. And it'll be a foul, a shooting foul. All he had to do was stand there. When you take that one step, you give up the foul. A lot of folks that watch ball don't realize position means you can't move a foot once the player leaves the floor. So Hubbard with two hits the first one. And that makes it 24-18. Seven fouls against the Red Devils. Three fouls against the Musketeers. Bobby Hale on the bench. Who'd they put in? Raby. Put Raby back in. Raby, Brewer, Miller, McKee, and Fannin. 25-18 for Greenup County. We have Wireman and Hughes, Hubbard, Grooms, and Jackson. I think that's who we started with. Brewer off the glass and in. Nice shot. I tell you, Landon Brewer, he's a hawk out there now.
He's tall.
Harold Jackson with a lot of pressure turns it over. Picked up by Raby down underneath. Landon Brewer up and in, and we're down to three now. 25-22 with 4:30 to play here in the first half. From Marv Meredith Gym, Gage Hughes down on the baseline, kicks it out. Foul against Brewer, just couldn't stop. One of those daggone fouls, isn't it? He was trying to get to the boards and let it get in his way. Dalton Duvall checks in for Brewer. Brewer picked up his second foul. I think maybe that he's trying to protect him a little bit. Up short, rebound comes off. Raby to McKee. McKee gets pressure from Grooms all the way to the corner, kicks it out. That's McKee had the ball. Down on the floor, we'll have a foul against number three, Michael Hubbard. And for Hubbard, that'll send common foul. And it'll be played out underneath as Ethan Raby will throw it in for the Red Devils. First foul against Hubbard. Out it comes to McKee. I think I called him Raby a while ago. Ended the ball. He's fouled on the way up. And I think this will be a two-shotter. Should be. It will be. Foul against Grooms. I'm sorry, Wireman is first. Fifth foul against Greenup County. They have another one to give before they face the bonus. Duvall, first shot up. Nice soft touch for a big guy. Nice touch. He's really come on since last year. Really has. 25-23. He could make it a one-point game and does. 4:10 to play. Greenup County's biggest lead was 8. And it's down, 9, and it's down to 1 now. Gage Hughes, three, no good. Duvall high in the air. Hey, and off the floor to get it, too. None of that standing there stuff.
Right.
McKee in the lane, gives it off, right, left side. Three, no good. Comes off as Fannin shot hit the back of the rim. They'll give it out front. He took steps, no whistle. Wireman, he comes in the middle. Should have been a foul. Puts it up and in is Grooms. 27-24. They fouled the other guy going in. Yeah, should have been a foul there. Going to be a little rough. And go to the by-back, carried the ball, was Michael Hubbard. That's the second one called on him tonight. I don't think Harold Tackett liked it much. He's clapping at the official, that ought to tell you. Pretty well officiated game tonight, though, really. It really has been. Not that what people care what we think, but we try to tell it exactly as we see it. Doesn't matter if Russell makes mistakes or Greenup makes mistakes. All good people, all playing hard. I'll say that now. 27-24 as Atkins brings it across for the Red Devils. He drives down, bounce, try to get it to the ball. Last touch by the ball, but Gage Hughes stepped in the way, and there wasn't much Duvall could do with the one hand because Hughes had blocked off the other hand. Gage Hughes, an outstanding young man, plays for Greenup County. And he can shoot the ball as they fight for it. Across the top it comes. Wireman gives it up. Brooms, he took steps, no call. There's Hubbard, free throw line left, too hard. Rebound, Greenup County. It comes off to Blake Burchett, and it comes back out to Grooms. I'm sorry, yeah, it's Grooms. Shot, and we'll call a foul on the ball, and all he had to do was stop, but he went that one more step. Once they leave the floor, you've committed yourself. But again, I think he's only played a couple seasons. You give him half dozen, 10 games, he'll improve.
He'll get it.
Austin Grooms to shoot two for the Musketeers. Nine fouls on Russell, five on Greenup County. A little too hard, back of the rim, comes out of there. We'd love to hear from you. We're glad to have you here on GreenupBeacon.com. No good, rebound comes off. Russell controls it finally. A lot of pressure, pushes the ball ahead. Comes down to Miller, he bounce passes to the ball. Miller should have took the shot. I do believe that. 27-24, and let's see, I see new numbers. Do I see any numbers that I haven't had? Maybe. I'll have to look around here in a minute. Yeah, there's Hughes. Hughes has it in the lane, stops, pops, puts it up and in. Back out to a five-point lead, 29-24. After Russell had come close, throws it away, trying to get it ahead, and that is guard for Russell is Jack Downs, and he'll come to the bench as Ethan Raby. In the lane, up, no good. On the back, no call, comes out. Hughes, three, no good. Rebound this time, Greenup County. Russell not getting to the boards like they should. Three, no good, rebound, Burchett. Or Hubbard. Hubbard with it. Now Jackson. Harold Jackson, left side, right side, it comes. There's steps called against Gage Hughes. That's the second time he's done it. They let it go the first time because he had pressure. And this time they called it. Tanner Miller to throw it in. Ethan Raby. I'd say Strader's done a pretty good job getting him ready. Three no good. Duvall high in the air. Off the glass. Daggone, it didn't go in for Dalton, but he'll play it underneath as he was fouled on the rebound, not on the shot. Out of bounds, common foul. It'll be first foul. Six fouls against Greenup County. So if there's another foul by the Musketeers on a floor play, it'll be 1-1. Raby, he wants it, doesn't, takes inside to Miller. Miller kicks it out, Raby saves it, free throw line right. Good! 29-26. Greenup County with a two-point advantage in this quarter. They were up one, they're up three. There's in the lane, Harold Jackson. Tipped up, no good. Russell controls it, comes out, should have been a foul. And they're going to call a foul, which was a foul, against number 25, Jared Fannin. Welcome to Russell. First one on the way by Hughes, good. Second one good. Across the line, Raby to Duvall, gives it up like he should. Miller down the lane and in. What a great hands-up play by Duvall. because he wanted to turn and he saw him coming.
Saw him. Got
him. Hughes. Gage Hughes, a great player for Greenup County. Jaharrell Jackson, the hero of the 63rd District Tournament last year, as he hit that last second shot to eliminate Lewis when really all hope was lost, to be honest.
Yeah, it was. Good ball player.
Great ball player, 31-28. So was Jahair, slouch either. I believe he's playing down at Berea this year. Michael Hubbard, two, no good, too hard. Duvall high in the air. Russell controls it. Should have been a foul on Wireman. No call, but they're going to call a foul on number 10, who is Blake Burchett, as they come up. And that, as I said, will give him the 1+1. McKee, I don't remember how he is at the free throw line, but a lot of pressure on him tonight. Out for Greenup is number 34, and that is Hunter Bentley. He'll be in the lineup. McKee with 1+1. Missed it. Comes off. 3-point lead. Greenup County can make it 5 or 6. Jahair Jackson out front. Cross courts it to Hughes. Hughes gets no pick, drives in the lane. Jackson takes it down, puts it up, too hard. Rebound inside. Greenup County up and in by Hunter Bentley. All the way down, up, and a foul called against Bentley. And to the lane, or to the line, will go Jared Fannin for the Red Devils. Brandon is a sophomore for Jason Strader, seeing varsity action in his first appearance, because I don't remember him last year. No, that's a mistake, an uncorrectable error. Is that a two-shot foul?
Yeah.
Oh, was it? Okay, I missed it. 3.9 at half of the second back. That's fair to Greenup County. That'll give him a shot at. Up the second one, good. So Fannin cuts it to 4. Here it comes, Hughes. Half court, stops. Got a 40-footer, missed it. Rebound, Dalton. But at the half, 33-29. 15 points in the quarter for Russell, 18 points in the quarter for Greenup County. We're at the half. It's Greenup County 33, Russell 29 here on Greenup Beacon and the OLBH Broadcast Network.
Let's welcome the national champion, Dancing Devil.
We're going to have a national champion. So I guess we're going to keep it here, Keith. Have to do a little work, even though we don't want to. Keith's hoping for a break and can't get it.
Haley Cocker, Emily Justice, Brianna Antis, Lauren Connolly, Laurel, Hensley, Savannah Hobbs, Faith Bevelheimer, and Jennifer Downey. They're coached by Lauren Gibbs Burgess.
Thank you.
Stay tuned for our halftime game sponsored by Chick-fil-A.
The Hearing Center at 1505 Carter Avenue in Ashland is the Tri-State's premier audiology center. The Hearing Center staff has been providing quality hearing and hearing aid services to Eastern Kentucky, Southern Ohio, and Western West Virginia since 1972. The Hearing Center offers four styles of hearing aids that professionals tailor to each patient's personal needs. The Hearing Center, 1505 Carter Avenue in Ashland, phone 606-324-0465.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Ohio University Southern offers more than 30 degree and certificate programs. Whether you're in Ohio or just across the river in Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
Heavenly Father, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunities it holds for growth, learning, and enjoyment, and for the time to share with others. I pray for peace and joy in mind, body, and spirit, and for the hope of this day. In your name, amen.
Super Quick owned Subways, you can buy 3 footlongs, $5 each, or a regular salad for $5, or mix and match any 3 salads or footlongs for $15.
Available only at these Super Quick Subways: Cannonsburg, Greenup, Cerrito, Ironton, Colgrove, South Point, Vanceburg, and Flatwoods.
Subway, eat fresh.
Hi, I'm Julie Reeves. You're watching GreenUpBeacon.com, a member of the Beacon Media Group.
The force, it's got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like that.
Hi, I'm Julie Reeves. You're watching GreenUp Beacon.
And we're at the half. It's Russell trailing Greenup County 33-29. Little halftime entertainment. Sponsored by one of our sponsors, Chick-fil-A. Hank Fong, Keith Atkins here with you. And we'll be back here with the beginning of the second half coming up here in just a couple minutes. This is the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network. Mar Meredith Gym, it's Greenup County 33, Russell 29 in boys action at the half. And we'll be on the air again tomorrow, 1 o'clock from Flatwoods, as the Flatwoods Parade. We'll be streaming it live with the audio from Susie Gullett and the one and only Mark Justice here on GreenupBeacon.com. December 6th at 2 o'clock, join Keith Atkins and me from Raceland High School for the Kentucky Junior All-Star Game. Teams have been slotted. I have most of the rosters ready, and we'll have a good afternoon of volleyball, best 3 out of 5. We had a great time a couple weeks ago over with Alan Perry at South Point, and it'll be another great afternoon of volleyball. Also coming up for us here on December 7th, join Keith Atkins at greenupbeaconradio.com as the Russell Middle School team entertains the Ashland Middle School teams, starting about 5:30 with the sixth grade, and they'll play 6, 7, and 8. Big Keith will be there in the corner trying to hide, but he'll bring you all the action of that. And then coming up on December 7th, it'll be Russell and Ashland girls here at Mar Meredith Gym, and it'll be a great night. I know that Keith hopes that he gets finished with the eighth grade game so he can run over and see the second half of the girls' game. It'll, you know, we do what we do, but I mean, with all I'm paying you, you can hurry it up, right? 33-29, back in a minute with the second half. This is the OLBH, Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network.
First and People's Bank has 6 convenient locations to serve you. From South Shore to the main office, First and People's Bank has been serving this area with complete banking services since 1932. Visit the home office near you, First and People's Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
We are the home office. Come visit any of our 6 locations.
Visit the Sungate Alpaca Company to experience the vibrant cultural heritage of South America and discover the extraordinary luxury fabric called alpaca. Wrap yourself in a stylish alpaca scarf. Transform your living room by adding texture and color with a hand-loomed alpaca throw blanket, and add a little extra warmth and cozy fashion with an alpaca hat and matching gloves. Visit sungatealpaca.com for all your alpaca needs. Find us on Facebook for special deals and inventory updates. Shop Sungate Alpaca.
Greenup County already out on the floor, 22 seconds. You know it's bad when you're 65 almost and your voice still cracks, right? 10 seconds till we start the second half. It'll be Red Devils ball across the way, as it'll be Tanner Miller to throw it in for Jason Strader's squad. Harold Tackett sends his team back on defense, and we're ready to get underway. 33-29. Greenup County leads. Russell hopes to cut into that quickly. It was Greenup County 15-14 at the end of the first stop, and 33-29 at the half. In junior varsity action, Russell with a strong second half took a 67-50 win. And there it is, Brewer in the lane, good. Landon Brewer with the bucket, 33-31. Pressure from Russell. Harold Jackson to Wireman, ahead of Gage Hughes. Hughes has it stolen away, picked up by Raby. Free throw line shot, good! We're tied at 33. First 4 points from Greenup County, or from Russell, ties Greenup County. Gage Hughes quickly down in the corner. In the lane to go. I see adjustment he made already. He put him in the passing lanes, because that's what was killing him in the first half. I mean, that doesn't mean that they'll win or anything, but he did make a big adjustment. Gage Hughes, Wireman 1-3, gets pressure. Ball goes inside, touch last, went off the head of Hubbard, and it'll be Russell's ball. Hubbard didn't like the call, but that's just the way it is. Official Landon Brewer put the ball out of bounds. It's time to go, man. That's the way it is. In it comes to Stump. Stump back in, Bobby Hale. He's got Tanner Miller, lays it up. And in, Russell's first lead at 35-33. 7:07 to play. Time runs down. Charge! No doubt about that. Tanner Miller stood his ground.
That's Russell's first lead tonight, isn't it? That Russell's first lead tonight.
It is. First lead, 7:07 in the third quarter. They've trailed the entire game, been down by as many as 8. And now the, oh, Stump was wide open. He didn't see. Strader to Ray, or Strader, I'm looking at Coach Strader. Raby in the corner, Miller. Pulls back out. One to go to Stump. Nowhere to go. Stump was open. Now Miller's tied up. Stump flashes over there. As you see, he gives it up to Miller. Miller inside, it goes to Brewer. Brewer wants to go to Stump. Takes it himself. Puts it in. 37-33. Russell with a 4-point lead as the Red Devils now begin to put some pressure on. Jahero Jackson with it. Another great ball player. Foul. Jackson tried to shoot it from the right side. Grooms has the ball. Well, we know the student body doesn't agree.
Yeah, they don't agree at all.
Two shots coming to Austin Grooms. Nice player for a senior for Harold Tackett. First shot up, good. McKee checks in. Stump goes to the bench. They'll put Miller underneath. McKee will be at out front. Shot on second one on the way. No good. Rebound controlled by Greenup County. Russell got in too quick. The ball popped out. Three! Gage Hughes ties it at 37. Musketeers found the range again. Hughes with a great shot. Pressure against Miller. I don't know where the count is, but they need to get it up there. Foul on Hughes. I saw that coming. Somebody was going to get a foul. Hank Bond, Keith Atkins here. McKee. He'll throw it in for the Red Devils. He'll throw it to Bobby Hale in the back court. Hale gets pressure right away from Gage Hughes. He drives down, back away. In it comes. Spin around, Miller, and a foul. Going to be called against number three, Michael Hubbard. I had looked down. I don't know how solid the foul that was. Three fouls on Hubbard, so we'll see Blake Burchard check back in for the Musketeers. Miller will shoot two. First shot on the way. Good. 38-37 Russell. Second one on the way. It's good. 39-37. Head it goes. Hughes. Burchard shot no good. Landon Brewer pulls it down. 5:29 to play, quarter three. Back to Bobby Hale. Hale looks at his coach. He knows where to go. Gets pressure from Hughes. A lot of pressure. He falls down. They're going to call a block. Playing underneath is McKee. Will throw it in for the Red Devils. And it comes. Brewer up short, and he's fouled. Foul against Wireman. 39-37. You know, Keith, I've been doing this for the better part of 50 years. And when the foul is on your team, it's let them play.
Yeah.
And when the foul's on the other team, it's that's a good call.
Right, yeah.
39-37. Great crowd on hand here at the Mara Meredith Gym. Almost full. Second one up and in. 3-point lead, Russell. 40-37 here in quarter three. And it comes to Harold Jackson. Almost threw it away. Hughes on this side. Spins against Raby, backs out, gives it to Jackson. Hughes will take it back from Jackson, come out up to point. Looks on the right side, backs up. There's Grooms with it. Bobby Hale came off of him. He's not a three. Hughes in the lane, 6-footer off balance, good. Nice shot, Gage Hughes. Unfortunately, they don't put up how many points you have anymore. They used to do that. Ahead it comes to McKee. McKee all the way in. Big block by Burchard. He saves it himself. He gives it off to Grooms, and Grooms will come across the timeline. Grooms goes over to Jackson. Jackson holds the ball out front. Russell with a one-point lead. Musketeers with the ball. Hughes down the lane. Foul out there. Common foul, and it comes up and in. Nice pass. They were ready for that. So Burchett with a bucket gives Greenup County the lead back. Ahead it comes to McKee. McKee stops back to Raby. He puts it up and in, and it's a one-point Russell lead. Foul over there will be a common foul. I guess against Bobby Hale. It is against Hale. And for Hale, his third. Five fouls against Greenup County, three against the Red Devils. And we'll see for Russell, Jared Fannin come in for Hale. Three-pointer, no good rim. Comes out, kicks it back. Jackson, he'll drive in. Spins around Fannin, puts it up, no good. Off comes Raby with it. Raby, he'll back up. He's got Fannin, almost stolen away by Burchett. Out of bounds. ...42-41, Red Devils lead, Greenup County in a tight contest. Not over and back, he didn't have possession. Got a half possession, McKee with it. Bounce pass inside of Brewer to the corner. Fannin has it, timeout Russell. Timeout, 30 seconds, back in a minute. This is the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network.
At Carmen Funeral Home for more than 100 years, the original mission of the firm hasn't changed. They've always intended to provide the best and most professional services complemented by the finest products. Stop in today and see Bob Green or Mark Ratliff at Carmen Funeral Home in Flatwoods. Carmen Funeral Home, people serving people since 1913, from pre-need to final arrangements. Carmen Funeral Home.
Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon.
42-41, the Red Devils lead. Timeout Russell after a little dive to the floor. Raby into Landon Brewer. Out to McKee. McKee back in the corner to Raby. Raby won the shot. Brewer in the lane. He's fouled. No whistle. Comes off. Brewer takes Jackson down the sideline. Inside it goes. Burchard has a block by Brewer. Oh, they're going to call a foul. I didn't really see if he got his arm or not. 42-41. Four fouls against the Red Devils. Two shots for Blake Burchard. Senior for Harold Tackett squad. First one up. Good. We're tied at 42. Dalton the ball in. Stump and Brewer on the bench. I bet we'll see him in the fourth all the way. Second one up. No good. Rebound. Greenup County. They try to tie him up. We're going to call a foul. Against McKee. No, I'm sorry. Who? Against Dalton Duvall. Hughes, 1-3. Free throw line, 2. No good. Rebound comes off to Russell. Raby, he's fouled. Wireman held him up. Duvall with it, puts it down. Foul on the way in. Foul going to be called against number 31, Austin Grooms. Tied at 42. On the way. Oh, yeah. We'll take that. They're not going to call a violation because the backboard's not out of bounds. It has to hit the top, and it did not hit the front. 43-42. On the way, good. Dalton DeVall with a couple from the free throw line, and Russell holds a two-point lead. Grooms, full court pressure, Russell. He's guarded by Raby. They give it to Jaharrell Jackson. Bounce pass to Grooms. Grooms in the corner. Wireman pulls up. Nope. Free throw line, Bertrick. Good. Tied at 44. I'll tell you one thing. Greenup County has real ball movement.
They really do.
The key down. He carried it. And so Greenup County gets it back. Tied at 44 and a chance to take the lead. Seth Atkins will check in for Jacob McKee. Gage Hughes, Wireman, Grooms, cross courts it to Hughes. Inside it goes. Up, and they're going to call a foul on the ball. 2-point lead for Greenup County. And to the line will go Jaharrell Jackson. Nathan Collins in, DeVall to the bench. DeVall wants to do well badly. Rebound, Gravy. Atkins with it, throws it ahead. Tanner Miller takes two steps, puts it up short. Intimidated him, fights around for it. Fannin gets it. Jared, baseline, shot up. Good! 46 all, 2:17 to play. Musketeers with it back. Wireman, he has it in backcourt. Comes up, almost stolen away by Fannin. It's tight down there on that bench, isn't it? Gage Hughes, double team, backs up, takes it down the side, goes around Fannin. Over left side goes to Jackson. Jackson stops, gonna drag that foot, didn't, went in the lane, Burchard up and in. I'm telling you, Burchard is good on the inside to not be a real tall player. Let's see, I'll try to figure out. He's 6'1". Miller, he gets fouled. That's gonna be Wireman on the way by, and a shot, no good. Common foul. Nope, one and one. One and one, and that'll send. Jordan Hill checks back in for Wireman. Tanner Miller at the line for the bonus. 48-46, Greenup County. Short. Rebound, Gage Hughes. A 1+1 is a double-edged sword, always has been, Keith. Hughes throws it up, got a break. Should have lost it, Bertrick. Jackson up and in, takes it 50-46. Four-point lead with 1:29 to go. .129 to play. Second foul against Fannin. 5-point lead now for Greenup County after they trailed by four all the way down. Fannin up and in. Nice move, and he's smooth on the glass now. 51-48. Reminds me a lot of Jackson when he gets down in the lane. He just turns on the smooth somehow. They choose a brilliant shot from the outside. Jackson great on the inside. Plus this Burchard for Greenup County, he's tough. All right, we're out front with it. Jackson, he'll drive in the lane, kick to the corner. Here's a three, no good. Rebound comes off Seth Atkins. Double teamed in the backcourt by Hughes. He needs help, comes ahead to Raby. Timeline, Raby all the way down, stops. He almost walked, didn't. Miller, he did. 51-48, 42 seconds to play, quarter three. We're going to see out number 20 for Russell, and that is Jax Downs. Saw him a little bit last year. Out for Greenup County, Hunter Bentley, and to the bench for Greenup County will go Austin Grooms. Front of the Russell bench, then it comes to Jackson. Pressure, double team, full court press, almost knocked away. Hughes holds it on the right side, 30 seconds to play. Jackson now with it out front. We're going to call a foul on Atkins as he did impede Burchett. One plus one for Burchett. Second foul against Atkins. Eighth foul of the half against Russell. We had a lot of fouls in this game, really. Up, no good, rebound, out of bounds, saved in, picked up Russell. Telling you what now, Jackson's going to draw a foul. That was kind of a foolish foul, but maybe he thought he had a clean shot at it. 21.4 seconds to go. Seth Atkins will step to the free throw line for the 1+1. Chaz Witt out for Russell. And he'll put Hunter Tanner Miller on the bench. ...51-48 with the bonus. Could cut it to one. On the way, good. Oh, is that, he gets a one plus one, right? So it is 51-49. A deuce, which is closer. Greenup County led by four at the end of three, or at the half, and they lead by two. And at this point, Atkins can cut it to one if he sails another free throw through. On the way, too hard. Rebound comes off Bentley. Here comes Jackson. 17 seconds to play. They want to get it to Hughes. He gets it now. Out front, Atkins with him. Hughes goes to the left, back to the right, spins around, gets picked off. Russell sags their defense out. Three! No good, too hard. Comes off to Russell, a shot by Fannin, and that's the end of the third quarter. It's Russell trails Greenup County, 51-49. Back in a minute on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network. ...51-49, we enter the final 8 minutes of regulation here at greenupbeacon.com, greenupbeacon2.com, and replay tomorrow on greenupbeaconradio.com. Always archived on the website, greenupbeacon.com, and it will be available audio only for those who can listen but can't watch. 51-49, Greenup County starts it here on the fourth quarter, and here we go. Gage Hughes gets Bobby Hale's defense. Landon Brewer out against Jackson. He backs up. Brewer, Jackson one to shoot. Burchett goes inside. Steps, should have been a walk. We're going to call a foul, but it should have been a walk. On Brewer. That'll be his 4th. Oh, no, I'm sorry. It was on 22. And that boils down to be 22. That's a rabies. Lost track there. Old man can't remember nothing. On the 1+1, Hubbard puts it in. 52-49, Greenup's lead back out to 3 as the Musketeers have led pretty much from the start. Russell's had a couple leads, one as big as 4 points. It's a 4-point lead for Greenup County. Full court pressure again. Hubbard against Raby. Landon Brewer and Burchard try to cut him off and dead. Ahead it comes. There's Bobby Hale. Gets a pick from Brewer. Hale dumps it off. Stump in the lane. Too hard. Rebound comes off. Brewer, he gets shoved. No call. They're going to call a foul out. He couldn't move. Foul against Greenup County. Number 10, and that's Blake Burchett. 9 fouls on both teams. So both teams from this point forward in the double bonus. But at the same time, this is a 2-shot foul. He tried to go back up with it. Jackson and Burchett underneath for Greenup County. Stump, Miller in the middle, and then Wireman and Gage Hughes. On the way, too hard, nope, went in. Bounced around. We're going to put Raby now, put Miller back. 53-50. Landon Brewer can cut it to 2. And it's on the way, too hard. Rebound, stump, had it. Jackson takes it. Across the timeline, all the way down, kicks it right, shot. No good. Rebound tip. No good. Put up Wyman. 55-50. Bobby Hale. Russell down by 5. 7:04 to play. In the lane. Bobby Hale double dribble. I started watching the ball as soon as I saw it was going to go up, so I couldn't tell you. That's why I bring Keith. He knows just enough to be dangerous about basketball. 55, well, that's okay, I don't know nothing. I just make it up as I go. Gage Hughes gets pressure from Stump, takes it all the way down. We're gonna call block. Oh, he took it in the face. Blooded his nose, maybe. Tanner Miller. That's why people don't take charges. Foul against Miller. Says he has 8 points. I don't know how accurate that is. Not. Hughes at the line. 5-point lead for the Musketeers. They play gutsy here in quarter four and pull right back out. They led by 2. Now they lead by 6. Russell scored 1 point in the quarter. Greenup County 5. Red Devils need pressure and some conversions. No good. It's a 6-point game. Landon Brewer to Bobby Hale. Cross court to Raby. Raby won the shot. Goes baseline to Miller. Miller backs up. Should have taken the 3. Didn't. Looks across. Raby 3. No good. Tapped around. Stump up. No good. They fight for it. Comes off. Jump ball. Possession, Russell. In the corner, there it is to Stump. Back out, Bobby Hale. In the corner, Raby, too hard. Rebound, Wireman. He did that 3 bad, Keith. 6:25 to play. Here comes Hubbard down all the way. Took a lot of steps. Rolls off. He picks it up. Going to have a foul called against Hubbard as Stump had it. We'll walk the floor. Both teams in the final 6:18 will shoot the double bonus. Hank Bond, Keith Atkins here on GreenerBeacon.com. We're glad to have you with us. Reminder, the game is archived at GreenerBeacon.com. and GreenupBeacon2.com. Also replayed on GreenupBeaconRadio.com. A couple more availabilities coming soon. Up and in. 56-51. Jacob McKee, he'll check in. The lefty for Russell. He'll take Raby's place as he runs off down underneath. Stump. Couple dribbles. Looks it up. Good. Swishes that baby. 56-52. What a game we have here at Mar Meredith Gym. Both teams playing well. Foul against Ryan Stump. So at the line will be Gage Hughes. At the line. You know, considering that Jason's in his first year here, they have adapted to his style pretty well. I mean, they're down five, but a lot of teams lose the first 8 or 10 under a new coach, and they may lose tonight, but Greenup County has played exceptionally well, particularly back on defense. McKee, he walked, no call, ball control Jackson. One thing I really like, and I'll share it in a minute, cross court. Wireman, three, no good. Passed around, McKee gets it. He'll bring it up. He wants to go all the way down, he does. Over Jackson, rolls it in. 57-54, 5:47 to play in regulation. Gage Hughes double team. Hale knocks it away from behind. Jackson picks it up as it rolls over. Down underneath it goes to Burchett. He puts it up and he's fouled. Now on Bobby Hale, 5-point lead. They'll send Burchett to the bench, or to the free throw line. 5:35 to play. Four fouls against Hale. Ryan Stump will check in. I don't know if it'll be for Hale, but he'll get the free throw. And it's on its way. Good. And he's in. Stump for Hale. Tell you, that was a gutsy play for Hale down inside. Timeout on the floor. Back in just a minute. This is the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network.
First and People's Bank has 6 convenient locations to serve you. From South Shore to the main office, First and People's Bank has been serving this area with complete banking services since 1932. Visit the home office near you, First and People's Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
We are the home office. Come visit any of our 6 locations.
Heavenly Father, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunities it holds for growth, learning, and enjoyment, and for the time to share with others. I pray for peace and joy in mind, body, and spirit, and for the hope of this day. In your name, amen.
Greenup County with a 6-point lead. Harold Tackett took a timeout. And so now Russell's out, Greenup County's out, and we're in the final 5:35 of regulation here in Mar Meredith Gym. It'll be Landon Brewer to throw it in for the Red Devils. And it comes into Stump. Stump. Raby. Pressure. He carried the ball. No call. Raby has it knocked away by Jackson. No doubter. Jackson takes it in the lane, spins, gives it off to Hughes. Up, no good. Should have been a foul there, no call. Over McKee, no good. On the back, and they're going to call it this time. Called against Austin Grooms. It'll be Tanner Miller at the free throw line, 60-54. Miller missed the first one. Gotta hit them. The three ones you gotta hit. On the way, short. Hit the rim, Jackson gets it. The pressure showed on those. 6-point lead, Greenup County, 5:05 to play in regulation. Walk called. Landon Brewer into Jacob McKee. McKee to Brewer was a pretty good football combination, too. We'll see Hubbard at the next dead ball. Hughes against McKee. Pressure inside. He drives down, bounces into Raby. Raby took steps, takes a shot, baseline, shoved it over the rim. Should have kicked it back out, maybe. 4:39 to go. Wireman with it out front. And now Austin Grooms has it. Full timeout for Greenup County. Back in a minute. This is the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network.
Stoltz Pharmacy is now offering patients compounding for their prescription needs. Stoltz Pharmacy is the only pharmacy in the area that is PCCA certified. We can provide you with hormone replacement, neuropathy creams, scar creams, pediatric prescriptions, and we can even help you with your veterinarian needs. If you have any questions, please call 606-834-1052. That's 834-1052. Stoltz Pharmacy in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stoltz Pharmacy.
Greenup County with a 6-point lead at 60-54, 4:31 to play in regulation. Coach Harold Tackett took a timeout to talk about his team's offense. They have, both teams have pretty much pressured the entire game. It'll be Grooms to throw it in. He comes back court to Jaharrell Jackson. We'll see Jared Fannin at the next dead ball. Jackson inside, goes to Hubbard. Hubbard puts it up. And they're going to call the foul on Stump on the way by. Two shots. That's five on Stump. He wasn't out there very long. And Jared Fannin will check in. First one to foul out tonight. A lot of fouls called, but to be honest with you, a lot of physical contact, and you have to keep some things in check. That's why when you hit me, I call the police. First one up, bounces out. Back of the rim. Hank Brown along with Keith Atkins on camera tonight. Second one good. 6-7 point lead. I guess we're going to spend a lot of nights in this gym.
Looks that way, doesn't it? Sorry. Like it.
Bobby Hale gets a pick from, he'll drive all the way down, bounce pass, went to Fannin. Fannin lost the handle, but found it back. Stolen away by Jackson. Jackson, all of, or that's, Hubbard picks it up, scores, and that's going to put Greenup County out by nine, 4:04 to play, and he'll go to the line and can make it a double-digit lead. Up, rims out. Landon Brewer with a rebound. He gives it back to Bobby Hale, and we come across the timeline. Timeout, Russell. A full timeout. Back in a minute. You're watching the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Ohio University Southern offers more than 30 degree and certificate programs. Whether you're in Ohio or just across the river in Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
Super Quick owned Subways, you can buy 3 footlongs, $5 each, or a regular salad for $5, or mix and match any 3 salads or footlongs for $15.
Available only at these Super Quick Subways: Canonsburg, Greenup, Cerrito, Ironton, Colgrove, South Point, Vanceburg, and Flatwoods.
Subway, eat fresh.
63-54, Greenup County is pulled away here, leading by 2 at the end of 3. They're now up by 9 with a 7-point run, and they have the opportunity now to put it away with another couple miscues by the Red Devils. Ender Raby, he gets a hand all the way in, and he's going to be fouled going to the basket. I don't know if it's going to be on Jackson. Yes, against Jaharrell Jackson. His 4th foul, and taking him out could be, if he fouls out, can change the total complexion of the game. We'll see Jacob McKee, and shot it too hard, but he got a lucky bounce and came back in. McKee in for Bobby Hale. Raby. On the way. Good. 63-56. 7 points. Jackson will pick it up. He has the baseline. Throws it in to Hubbard. Going away. McKee all the way down around. Jackson puts it in. And it's a 5-point game. 63-58 with 3:46 to go. And I do know, nice block stolen away. Ahead it comes, McKee. He'll drive. Give it to Brewer. Up it in! 63-60. And with a foul, Brewer will go to the bench. 5 fouls, and that's just what I said, wasn't it? I mean, I wasn't wishing on him. I mean, I want him out there the whole game, because then you see what you've got. So he hits it, and it's a 2-point game. It's short. Comes off Wireman. That's the second time he's hit the front of the rim. I think he's thinking about it too hard. Jay Hughes, cross-court pass. Hubbard, he walked. And now Hughes back with it. Baseliner, short, rebound, McKee. McKee brings it up, looks over, passes to the corner, going to be a charge. Wasn't much doubt on that one. When he looked to pass, that told me all I need to know. 3:16 to play. What a great ball game to start the year for Russell. 63-60. Greenup County playing right on their toes. Musketeers looking to go to 2-0, their season opening win against Johnson Central. Wireman, pressure from Brewer. Full court pressure, Fannin. Grooms with it. Gage Hughes, they're going to back it out. They're going to let the air out a little bit until they have a real shot. They don't want to be like Hoosiers and fire up one of those desperation shots with the lead. You don't have to do that. Foul on McKee, and Hubbard will go to the bench to shoot 2. And no doubter is Bobby Hale check in, and he'll come in for, I think, probably for Jacob. For Christmas, would you buy me one of those seats? First one up in here. Was that a no, or a maybe. The only thing I'm going to tell you is this. No seat. Harley knows where the money is. She hits the second one. He hits the second one. Harley being Keith's daughter, one of my favorite little buddies. She even talks to me now. Bobby Hale out front. Miller! No good. Rebound Fannin. Fannin up. Didn't shoot it hard enough. Brewer up and puts it in. 65-62. 3-point game. Greenup County with the lead and the ball. 2.5 to play. Hughes comes down. Backs it out. He has pressure from Hale. They give it to Hubbard. Hubbard drives it down the lane. Puts it up. No good. Nice rebound. Burchett. Ball tapped out of bounds. Saved in. And just going to be an out of bounds play. McKee comes back in for Hale. I see platoon for defense and offense. I see that. McKee ain't afraid of nothing.
Right.
I'm not inferring that Bobby is. I'm just saying, you play football, you're not afraid of anything. He walked. Reverse layup by Groom. 67-62. Back out to a 5-point stretch with 2:04 to play as McKee crosses the timeline. Gets pressure from Hughes. He'll drive down, stop, and he's fouled on the way in. Foul against Gage Hughes. He really didn't have any choice. He's given him the lane, didn't he? Once you give up that lane, you either foul or step out of the way. Yeah. Of course, I thought that maybe Burchett was going to slide over, and but he didn't. Nathan Collins, 57-62. Too much pressure out there for these guys.
They tied up. They hit them free
throws. Oh yeah, yeah. We've struggled at the line here a little bit. And he hits it. 4-point game, 67-63. All the way down, Hubbard, corner. Burchett in the lane, puts it up. He's fouled. Bobby Hale, he'll check in. Foul McKee. Hale, he'll check in on the second shot. That's 4 fouls on McKee. Bobby Hale back in. Oh, he sends Collins to the bench. Excuse me. 1:49 to play. Six-point lead for Greenup County. Russell in need of a basket. Miller all the way down. Up, no good. Rebound Brewer. Nope, couldn't handle it. Ball with it, Burchett. Here comes Hubbard. Gets pressure from behind, down in the lane. Puts it up. Good. That's Austin Grooms. 1:27 to play on the right side. Raby. 3! No good. Rebound. Greenup County and a foul on Brewer. 8-point lead. One thing I've really noticed tonight when Strader or Harold Tackett has made a change, there was a purpose. It was not just because somebody made a mistake or they changed their offensive or defensive scheme each time. Quite impressed. First one up, good. 9-point lead for the Musketeers. And it's double digits. 73-63. Russell without a basket puts themselves out of the ball game. Raby wanted a three, couldn't get the pick from Miller, was too close. Raby in the lane, throws it up, gets his own, puts it up, no good. Rebound comes out. Bobby Hale takes it out in front of Hubbard. He walked. They give it to McKee. McKee drives all the way down. He bounces it to Brewer up. Good. No fouls, I guarantee you on that.
Timeout
on the floor. We'll be back here in a minute. This is the OLBH Greenup Beacon Radio Network.
Heavenly Father, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunities it holds for growth, learning, and enjoyment, and for the time to share with others. I pray for peace and joy in mind, body, and spirit, and for the hope of this day. In your name, amen.
First and People's Bank has six convenient locations to serve you. From South Shore to the main office, First and People's Bank has been serving this area with complete banking services since 1932. Visit the home office near you, First and People's Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
We are the home office. Come visit any of our six locations.
...73-65, Greenup County with the lead. Our winner of Chick-fil-A tonight, Bob Hammond. And here we go. Inbound it comes. Hubbard, pressure in the backcourt from Collins. Grady takes it away, and a foul against Hubbard. Five fouls. This game is, for all practical purposes, barring some massive meltdown, the game's over. Anyway, Bob Hammond of Russell, our Chick-fil-A winner, we thank you for entering. One more chance to win at the end of regulation if you so want to enter for Chick-fil-A product. On the way, good. Raby gets one. It's a 7-point game. He got it to five. But that's a 2-possession game in 48 seconds. And it's up. Good. Full court pressure from Russell. Wireman with it. Throws it in to Hughes. Hughes has it. Crosses the timeline. He's fouled by Collins. Wasn't really any choice. Tanner Miller will check in. Considering the B game went on for our junior varsity, this game has clicked right along, even with all the fouls. 45 seconds to play, 6-point lead for the Musketeers. Up, good. Gage Hughes, a little insurance for Greenup County. We'll see Atkins to the bench, Collins to the bench, Fannin to the bench. So Hughes. It's on the way. Good. 8-point lead for the Musketeers in a hard-fought game. Greenup County really out there with it. Better take a timeout. Throws it, intercepted Wireman. Wireman in the lane, dribbles it back out, lets the air out. Foul by Raby. 40.6 seconds. Two free throws for Wireman on the double bonus. Two fouls on Raby. Up, it's off. Just don't mess up your camera work, Keith, so I can lean back here and watch the rest of it, okay? Second one up. It's good. Graham County with a 9-point lead as the Musketeers have about put this one away. Turnover, Russell. Collins will check back in for Russell, as will Seth Atkins. He'll check in for Landon Brewer and Bobby Hale, or... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's put more in than I didn't see one, I think. Collins Atkins football pass all the way down. Hughes stops, pops. He'll take two. Foul by Atkins. I think, We might have wanted an intentional foul there. I thought it was pretty hard play, but I don't know about that so much. On the way, no good. So we see Hale, Miller, and Brewer back in. Fannin, Collins, and Atkins out. So we pretty much have a pretty good idea of what we're going to see. And if Dalton can get a little bit more playing experience, we'll see Duvall in there. Second one is no good. Rebound, Burchett, Greenup County. Finally knocked away by Russell. Miller, they're all over him, going to have a foul on Burchett. I don't know why they would really do that. I'd have let him drive it down and shoot it, I think. Because you don't want to let any team score points with the clock stopped. Miller with two free throws. First one in front of the rim. Well, Keith, there's no doubt that had Russell hit its free throws, we would be tied. Because they missed at least 10. And a front end of a bonus a couple times, it bites you. But that's all right. There's a lot of games left in this season. Second one up. Good. 76-68, 8-point lead to Greenup County. Lots of pressure out there. In it comes. Atkins with a foul. 29.1 seconds. Brewer, Miller, and Hale will check in after the first free throw. This game in a week could have an entirely different outcome. Either way. 77-68, a 9-point lead for the Musketeers. I love these kind of games, though. All the money. 77-68. A free throw makes it a 10-point lead and done. 10-point lead for the Musketeers. I believe that's their biggest lead of the night. Had 9 a couple times. Bobby Hale, clock running, 22 seconds. McKee into Brewer. He's fouled by Burchett. Russell's substitutions will come in.
At the line, 32. Brewer.
Been a great game here, Mar Meredith Jim. Take Burchard out. Is that 5? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 out there. Somebody has to come out. Yeah, he's the fifth foul. Okay. Fifth foul on Burchard. I thought that's what it was, and then all of a sudden there's 6 out there. I think Burchard thought he was supposed to go back. At the line, Brewer, first one. He can't buy one tonight, can he? And Brewer with the second one to come to make it a 9-point game with 19 seconds to go. And it's up and in. Collins in. Brewer out. Fannin in. He thought he was coming out. Full court pressure. Baseline open. Grooms. Gives it to Hughes. Hughes fouled from behind. Fannin. Seconds to go. Hughes with 2 can make it an 11-point advantage. First one up. Good. Collins, Fannin, Atkins out. Hughes has it at 10. Second one up, 11. 16.4, seconds to play. Ahead it comes. Bobby Hale has it, looks in the corner. Ravy, three, good! Timeout Russell, 11.4 seconds to go. 8 points. We'll be back here in just a moment. You're watching the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Ohio University Southern offers more than 30 degree and certificate programs. Whether you're in Ohio or just across the river in Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
At Carmen Funeral Home for more than 100 years, the original mission of the firm hasn't changed. They've always intended to provide the best and most professional services complemented by the finest products. Stop in today and see Bob Green or Mark Ratliff at Carmen Funeral Home in Flatwoods. Carmen Funeral Home, people serving people since 1913, from pre-need to final arrangements. Carmen Funeral Home.
Final 11.4 seconds of the game. In it comes. Wireman with it. Head it goes. Russell gets it back. Ravy, three, no good. In it, Atkins, corner, McKee, no good. 80-72. Greenup County gets the win. Russell drops to 0-1, and Greenup County improves to 2-0. We'll be back here in a minute with a quick wrap-up, and we thank you for joining us here at greenupbeacon.com. Final score here at Marv Meredith Gymnasium was Greenup County 80 and Russell 72. Musketeers led at all four stops, 15-14, 33-29 at the half, 51-49 at the third stop, 80-72 is the final. Russell had a couple short leads, but Greenup County, a great effort tonight. Both teams, Greenup County coming out on top, managing to drop a few shots in that Russell could not seem to get to fall. A couple turnovers costly to both teams, but again, Greenup County with a great outcome tonight for the Musketeers of Harold Sackett. 2-0 they are on the year. The final score, 80-72. Tonight's exciting basketball action brought to you here on Greenup Beacon and greenupbeacon2.com. Replayed on Greenup Beacon Radio tomorrow. Was brought to you by Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital and the Greenup Beacon. Also brought to you by our corporate sponsor, First and People's Bank, the Sungate Alpaca Company, Carmen Funeral Home, Handyman Plus, Stoltz Pharmacy, ACTC, Greenup County EMS, and Buddy Galliard. Also brought to you by the Hearing Center, Ohio University Southern, the Subways of Superquick, and our prizes tonight from Chick-fil-A. Again, final score here was Greenup County 80 and Russell 72. wrestle tomorrow night. We'll play in the EKC tournament over at West Carter, officially home again on December 15th. We will have their action in Greenup and Raceland's action in the Raceland tournament coming up. And for Greenup County, they don't play again till December the 10th, as they'll play Portsmouth Notre Dame. Their schedule doesn't indicate where that game is. So nonetheless, it'll be Greenup County and Portsmouth Notre Dame on December 10th. For Keith Atkins and the entire broadcast team, this is Hank Bond. Thanks for joining us tonight here on GreenupBeacon.com. You're watching the OLBH Greenup Beacon Broadcast Network.